Sir, sabi niyo may mga wrong facts yung mga ilang kritiko, pero hindi po pa po namin narinig sa DFA yung mga facts talaga na meron yung gobyerno na mako-confirm po natin. So, what are the facts? How many ships were there? What were they doing? How long, etc.
Okay. As I said, no, we will tell you that we are taking the diplomatic actions. But if we tell you every step of the way and all the facts, etc., it will not help. Unless there is something that happened, diba, that the public has to know or that will not affect the negotiations. So, ang sinasabi ko, it's wrong dahil sinabi may invasion. Paano magkakaroon ng invasion kung wala namang umagaw o tatayo dun sa sandbar na yon? What's the proof? What's the facts? Kumuha kayo ng bangka. Pwede naman kayo lumapit dun eh.
Sir, so diba? What are the facts?
Tapos, look at it.
What are the facts? That answer can only come from you.
Let me apologize and I hope you not only listen but you also hear what I'm saying. We cannot go into all the facts or some of the facts at times because it will harm our job. My job is to protect the Philippine claim and the Philippine public. Diba? So, hindi natin strategy ngayon na lahat ng problema. Diba? So, halimbawa, nag-aaway kayong mag-asawa. Dati ang strategy nyo sa media, I'm not referring to anyone, ha? Sa media kayo nag-uupakan. Oh. You're trying to resolve it. May marriage counselor na kayo. Diba? Oh. Dati, ikaw naghahanap ng reporter kasi sa public ang strategy mo na ipitin o i-divulge yung sa asawa mo. Now you're trying to settle it in for the family. Do you go to the media every time, or if the media goes to you and tells you, oh, ano sabi ng asawa mo ngayon? O pinuntahan ka ba sa bahay? Inano ka ba? O etc. Of course, you'll keep quiet about it because it will harm the negotiations, no? But of course, for example, if we may danger or hindi nagwo-work yung strategy, no? Meaning halimbawa, hindi nasunod yung DOC, biglang may nag-inhabit ng uninhabited or may nagbi-build. Then we will tell you honestly, eto facts, eto nangyayari, hindi nagwo-work ang strategy. As I told you, when President Duterte came in, magtatayo sana sa isang bagong lugar, no, ang China. But because of the good relations, because of the mechanism, no, we agreed, di ba? Let's de-escalate. And nakikinabang yung buong region at yung ASEAN. So again, apologies, I know it's your job to ask for the facts. But it's my job naman to keep the negotiations going and not to hamper it.
Okay. Sir, sinasabi ng CSIS na hindi na lang right to innocent passage yung in-exercise ng Chinese ships, kundi may dalawa rin, at least dalawang nangingisda rin. At sabi rin ni Justice Carpio, mga ilang araw na silang nandun, so it could not be innocent passage only or freedom of navigation. How would you respond to that?
First, there's a difference between innocent passage and freedom of navigation. Okay. Number two, as to fishermen, ano ba nakalagay sa... Yun ang sinasabi ko, hindi tayo pwedeng inconsistent. Sa arbitration award, in certain areas, di ba, nakita doon na nirecognize na traditional fishing ground hindi lang ng Pilipinas. Vietnamese, Chinese, etc. Certain areas, ha, dahil iba-iba yung decision sa iba-iba lugar. Number two, pagdating sa fisheries at saka sa carbon deposits, no, hydrocarbon sa ilalim, no one owns that until hinarvest mo. Kaya tayo nag-uusap ngayon. And then lastly, remember, we're dealing with artisan fisheries or fishermen. Kapag commercial, itataboy talaga kasi masisira yung ecological balance. So, again, what do I say about CSIS? It's a good think tank. Its transparency project does a lot to help. But let's not forget that it's also an American think tank na American interest. Diba? So, the US has a strategy for Asia. China has a strategy for Asia. Japan has a strategy for Asia. We don't want to follow any of their strategies. We want to have a Philippine strategy for Asia. So the CSIS did not tell us anything we did not already know. Diba? But they're making conclusions without complete facts. Diba? So yun ang ano namin sa kanila. Continue what you're doing and we will answer you. But ang hinihingi namin sa inyo sa Philippine media, di ba? Itignan nyo rin sa sinasubmit nila. At tignan nyo rin yung pinanggagalingan nila. Do you think the CSIS or any American think tank will come out with findings or with statements or press release, etc., that are against American interest? Diba? Ang purpose nila is American interest. That's why when I was still a senator, I 100% supported, I continue to support, despite the difference of strategy, yung efforts ni Justice Carpio na magkaroon ng think tanks ang Pilipinas, especially in maritime security and the West Philippine Sea, because dyan may institutional memory. May taga, ano din, taga-push ng Philippine interest. Iba lang ang strategy namin ngayon. So, message ko sa CSIS, we're dealing with it. No, we're dealing with it, but from the point of view of Philippine interest. When our interest coincides with America, then you will have us there. When our interests diverge, we will follow Philippine interests. But let's make no doubt, there is no identical interest with the Chinese, with the Japanese, with the Australians, with the US, with the EU. There are common values and there are interests that intersect. Pero hindi ibig sabihin pareho. Diba? Hindi ito parang sabihin nyo, hindi, isang pamilya lang tayo. Yung interest ng pamilya, when you talk about interest ng pamilya, dalawa lang yan. Philippine at ASEAN. Kasi we're trying to have a one identity sa ASEAN. No? But the outside players have their own agenda. We won't be blind to it, but we also won't